हाय हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग, हैव अ नाइस डे. गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. ड्यू टू सम टेक्निकल रीजंस दिस सेशन वाज नॉट मेड लाइव इन द यस्टरडे सेशन इन द यस्टरडे, राइट? सो वी आर सॉरी फॉर दैट डिले एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू दिस रिकॉर्डेड वर्जन. सो इफ यू गेट एनी डाउट्स ड्यूरिंग व्हाइल वॉचिंग द रिकॉर्डेड वर्जन, please post your doubts in a comment box so that definitely I'll get back to you. Personally, I'll get back to you and try to comment, try to resolve your doubt. I'll try to resolve your doubt. Okay. So my sincere request is, if the video looks like very slow, you can make it on the different speeds, like 1.2 speed or 1.25 speed, so that you can finish off this session very quickly. All right, sir. And once again, good morning. Good morning, everyone. So we are going to discuss about star delta transformation. Much before this one, I have did not finish this nodal analysis and mesh analysis. I have three problems on nodal and mesh. After that, we will move on to star delta transformation. Okay, so let's move on. Right, before moving on to the session, this is a small introduction about myself. My name is Naveen Gollapalli. I have around 7+ years of experience in teaching. Most of the times I'll be teaching machines, measurements, and networks. And this is my Telegram channel where you can join in and download your study materials. I have uploaded study materials for the above mentioned subjects. You can ask your doubts also, by the way, wherever if you watch while watching my sessions, if you get any doubt, you can post your doubts. And not only the doubts, you can post your own questions also, right? Like maybe previous year questions or any kind of questions, text questions you can post so that I'll try to answer. Right, sir. I'm very much happy to answer. In our group, very much active participation is going on. Please, you also join in and participate in this solving the doubts. And these are the courses from GradeUp Super Platform. Those who are preparing for engineering services and GATE 2022, they can prefer either English language-based course or Hindi language-based course. Okay, so if any student want the lectures in Hindi, they can go for Vision 2022 Hindi. Right. These are the course features. The course features are going to be same, sir, for 2022. But for 2023 aspirants, here also you'll be having separately Hindi and English course, and you have here different number of classroom lectures. And classroom lectures are going to be different because it is a almost like 2 years program now, so it will be lengthy. Long term, it's a long term, so you'll be getting some more extra number of hours compared to these courses, right? If you want some other details, if you want extra details about these courses, you can call to this contact number, right? Chalo. By the way, this is the question which I have given in the last session. There's a question which I have given in the last session, right? Let me show you this question fully. I'm hiding myself. You can see it. He has mentioned that if VA minus VB is equals to 20 volts, then VC minus VD is dash. A terminal is here, B terminal is here. So the difference between these two terminals he has mentioned as, the difference between these two terminals he has mentioned as 10 volts, right? So let me take up 10 volts here. So obviously VB terminal or B terminal is going to be negative. So 10 divided by 2, 5 amperes you are going to get. The current has to flow like this from A to B. So entering terminal will be positive. So you are going to get 10 divided by 2, you are going to get it as 5 amperes. Okay. Now, one small point I wanted to say here. This entire part I am considering as circuit A. And this entire part, I'm considering it as circuit B. Okay, sir. Right. Now, according to KCL, whatever the current which is left from the circuit, that entire current has to come back. That entire current has to come back. So circuit A is giving 5 ampere or delivering 5 amperes to the circuit B. So circuit B is receiving 5 amperes. Now it has to deliver back. It has to deliver back. I'm representing at the bottom, right? So you look at this now. Junction. So for that junction, 5 ampere is entering. For that junction, 5 ampere is entering and 2 ampere is entering. So remaining current will leave as the current, the sum of the currents will leave from the junction as 7 amperes. If 7 amperes current is flowing through 1 ohm resistance, then you will get 7 volts voltage drop. So here I can say my D terminal is going to become positive and C terminal is going to become negative. Therefore, I can write Vc minus Vd is equals to minus 7 volts. Minus 7 volts. So B is the answer. Sir, why I am doing like this? Because ultimately I want the potential difference between C and D. The potential difference between C and D, how can you calculate? The voltage across current source or the voltage across 1 ohm resistor? We cannot calculate voltage across ideal current source, right? So, of course, this is a practical current source, that is fine. Along across the current source, I have 1 ohm. So, I am able to calculate voltage drop now. So that's the reason why I am trying to find out the current flowing through 1 ohm resistance. If I am able to calculate current flowing through 1 ohm resistance, I can calculate the potential at C and D, or potential difference between C and D. Okay, sir. So if it is not clear, please comment in the comment box so that I will try to respond. That is what, sir. This is in a bigger manner. I have represented in bigger manner. That's it. If the previous diagram looks like smaller, you can assume here 5 amperes you'll get, right? So that 5 amperes is entering here and it has to, maybe divides in multiple ways and ultimately it has to come back. Okay, that is what I have explained. Yeah, look at this one. That was a homework question of the yesterday's, you know, the last session. Now let us look into the question here. He's asking the potential difference between A and B. So I want potential at A, I want potential at B. If I am able to calculate potential at A and potential at B, I am able to calculate potential difference now. Okay, so this question can be solved with nodal analysis. So in the nodal analysis, you have to identify principal nodes. You have to identify principal nodes and assign the voltages, write the KCL equation, convert into Ohm's law. These are the steps I'm writing now. So I wanted to find out these two principal node voltages. Let's see how many principal nodes are there. So this is one principal node where at least minimum three branches should be connected. So A is one principal node. Now, similarly, B is also one principal node. I am mentioning it as VB. Now, here also, 10 ohm resistance, 6 ohm resistance, 10 volts voltage source. Three branches are connected. This is also principal node. Now, 10 volts voltage source, 4 ohm resistance and 2 ohm resistance are connected. Three branches are connected. This is also a principal node. Out of 4 principal node, you assume any one principal node as ground node or reference node. So, this voltage is going to be known. If it is connected, if it is assigned as ground, so its potential is going to be zero, right? Now from the ground, if you move like this, we are crossing 10 volts voltage source. Now at this, by this terminal, if you move from ground to this terminal, you'll be getting 10 volts. Yes or no? Only voltage source is there, no resistor is there. Now if you move from here to a terminal or this principal node, we are going to get a voltage drop. We do not know what is the current flow in the 10 ohms. Similarly, we do not know what is the current flow in the 6 ohms. So that is the reason why we are just assuming it as VA and VB. Out of 4 principal nodes, 2 principal node voltages are known. Remaining 2 principal nodes are unknown. Now we need to calculate those node voltages, right? So what I am doing now is I am writing KCL at node A. KCL at node A. So I am assigning it as I1, I2 and I3. So I am writing KCL now. Algebraic sum of currents leaving from the node A is equals to 0. There is a first step. After identifying the principal nodes, okay, write KCL equation. Then convert into Ohm's law. How can I write Ohm's law? I1 can be written as potential difference divided by resistance. Potential difference is VA minus 0 divided by resistance. VA by 10. I2 I can write it as VA minus 10 divided by 4. Yes or no? This is the terminal. At this terminal, VA is a potential. At this terminal, 10 volts is a potential. So VA minus 10 divided by 4. Okay, sir. Now I3 is going to be the directly current source value, that is 3 amperes. Now you solve this one, you will get VA value. You will get VA value. Let me take up VA as common. So 1 by 10 plus 1 by 4 is equals to 10 by 4 is 2.5, minus 2.5 and plus 3. So you are going to get it as minus 2.5 plus 3 means obviously 0.5. If you turn on to the right side, it will be minus 0.5. So this is my VA. VA will be minus 0.5 divided by, obviously 1 by 4 is 0.25. This is 0.1, so 0.35 you are going to get. This is my VA voltage. Alright, sir. So similarly, you can calculate for VB. Let me show you on the next diagram here. So here also I am applying KCL again. Here also I am applying KCL, right? So let me, already I have assumed it as I1, I2, I3. Let me make it as small I1. Small I1, small I2, small I3. Okay. Now KCL at B node will give you small I1 plus small I2 plus small I3 is equal to 0. What is small I1? It is quite opposite to 3 amperes current source, no? So I can write it as minus 3 amperes. What is small I2? Small I2 will be VB, potential difference divided by resistance. VB minus 0 divided by 6. What is small I3? Potential difference divided by resistance. Sir, if you have any doubt how potential difference divided by resistance, simply disconnect that branch. Disconnect that branch. Let me show you. This is how it looks like. If you have doubted 2 ohms, if you have doubted the current flowing through 2 ohms. Now simply do like this. This side, right side is potential as VB. Left side, the potential as 10. Which means these are the potentials assigned with respect to ground, sir. So, let me show you here like this. This will be 10 volts. And this will be VB volts. Now this is my ground, this is my ground. Did you get me, sir? Did you get me? Did you understand? I have just disconnected this branch and I have assigned the potentials. Okay. Now, if you want current, what is the current flowing through this 2 ohms? We have assigned it as I3. So let us write KVL now. I'm considering leaving terminals. So positive. Okay. Positive VB. Now here, before writing KVL, please do not forget to assign the polarities across each and every branch according to the current direction. Okay, so plus VB now, next minus 2 into I3, next minus 10 is equal to 0. So I3 is equals to VB minus 10 divided by 2. That is what we are going to write here. Potential difference divided by resistance, VB minus 10 divided by 2 is equal to 0. In the same manner, in the last step also, we have written same, VA minus 10 divided by 4. So solve this one, you are going to get VB as 1 by 6 plus 1 by 2. 10 by 2 is minus 5. Of course, minus 10 by 2 is minus 5. And minus 3 is there, minus 8. You'll get, so send on to the right side, you'll get 8. So if you solve VB, you'll get it as 8 divided by 1 by 6 plus 1 by 2. So once you get VA value, VB value, you take the difference. Take the difference. How? Oh, if you have any doubt, VA, VB is going to be VA minus VB. If you have any doubt, simply again assign these terminals. This is my A terminal, this is my B terminal with respect to ground only. So this is VA and this is VB. Okay, the potential difference between these two terminals is going to be VA minus VB. You see here, this is my VAB. Okay, write KVL, you'll come to know that. Plus VA, I'm moving like this, plus VA and minus VAB, minus VB is equal to 0. Wherever I've started, I came there itself. So plus VA, minus VAB, minus VB is equal to 0. So VAB is equals to VA minus VB. So this value and this value, you subtract, you will get the answer. Probably the answer will will be around 12.7 or minus 12.7 would be the answer. You subtract these two, you'll get the answers. Okay, sir. Right. If you do not, if this solution is not clear, please comment in the comment box. Right. So that I'll respond. Okay. Now next question we'll see again on nodal analysis. What he's asking? He's asking determine the power consumed by 2 ohm resistance. Where is 2 ohm resistance? 2 ohm resistance is here. If you are able to calculate voltage across this resistance, voltage square divided by resistance is a power consumption. Or otherwise, if you are able to calculate the current flowing through this resistance, current square into resistance, you are going to get power consumption. If you want to know the current or otherwise voltage, first you should know the potential difference at this terminal, at this terminal. Okay. To find out the potential at the terminals, apply nodal analysis. Nodal analysis will give you the node voltages. If you know the node voltages, you can calculate each and every branch currents. Once you calculate each and every branch current, you can calculate the voltage drop, of course, power dissipations, or otherwise energy dissipations. Okay, so before you are going to write node analysis, identify the principal nodes. This is one principal node, this is one principal node, this is one principal node, and this is one principal node. 4 principal nodes are there. Out of them, I am assigning this as one ground node. So this node voltage is 0. Now, if you move from the ground to this principal node, we are crossing only 12 volts voltage source. So the potential we are going to obtain is 12 volts. Plus 12 volts. If in this branch, if in this source, we have negative terminal as top terminal as negative, then you are going to get negative 12 volts. If you are going to have positive terminal as top terminal as positive terminal, you are going to get plus 12 volts. Right. Now, similarly, if you are moving from here to here, I am going to get plus 2V0. Plus 2V0. Here to here, we do not know. Through 8 ohms, we do not know. Because current is, we do not know. Right. So, I am assigning it as simply V. Simply V. Now, apply right KCL. So, I am writing it as I1, I2 and I3. Okay. KCL at node V, I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equals to 0. Convert into Ohm's law. I1 will be written as V minus 0 divided by 8. So V by 8. I2 can be written as equal to 3 amperes or not. Why? Because I2 direction, 3 amperes current source direction. Both are in the same direction. I3 is like this. So potential difference divided by resistance. Potential difference is V minus 12 divided by resistance is equal to 0. So do not include V0, sir. V0 is just like a drop across 2 ohms. Okay. So if you solve, you are going to get 1 by 8 plus 1 by 2 is equals to 3 minus 12 by 2 means minus 6. So 3 minus 6 is going to be minus 3. Send on to the right side, you will get 3. So V will be 3 divided by 1 by 8 plus 1 by 2. 1 by 8 means obviously you are going to get a very small value, 0.125. So plus 0.5. 3 divided by entire 1, you are going to get it as 4.8. 4.8 V. So V is 4.8. This value is 4.8. Okay. What I want voltage drop across 2 ohms, or otherwise I want current flowing through 2 ohms. If I can calculate voltage drop or otherwise current, then I can get power dissipation. Okay. So here, now let me show you my 2 ohms resistance. This side 12 volts and grounded. This side V volts and grounded. So what is that V? That V is 4.8. So I want only the voltage drop across this resistance or otherwise current. You can calculate any current or otherwise voltage, fine. Anything is okay. Right. Let's see. So 12 minus 4.8 divided by, you can write like this, na? KVL. You can write this KVL. Maybe I3 is flowing from bottom to top. I am assigning now. It is okay. I am assigning a new current I here. So you are going to get, let me hide, so you are going to get plus 12 minus V naught minus 4.8 is equal to 0. So V naught is equals to 12 minus 4.8. 12 minus 4 is going to be 8, so obviously 7.2 volts you are going to get. That's it. Or otherwise, simply you substitute this V naught, substitute this V here, I3 equation. Y3 is equal to V minus 12 divided by 2, na? So 4.8 minus 12 divided by 2, again you are going to get minus 7.2. Current as minus 7, minus 7.2 divided by 2. In the opposite direction, if you are getting current as negative, that means what? In this direction current will not flow, in this direction current will flow. So once you get this one, once you get V naught, you can calculate power consumption by 2 ohms resistance. 7.2 whole square divided by 2 ohms. So how much you are going to get, sir? 7.2 square divided by 2 ohms. V square by R. You are going to get it as around 25.92 watts. Okay. I just wanted to tell you one thing here. Please concentrate, everybody. Here. That is, you might know between the adjacent meshes, this is one closed path, one mesh I can say. This is one closed path, one mesh. This is one closed path, one mesh. There are three meshes, right? Between the adjacent mesh, this is mesh 1 if you assume, mesh 2 assume. Between the adjacent meshes, there is an ideal current source. I can call this network as super mesh network. If you apply mesh analysis, you cannot write mesh analysis here, because while writing mesh analysis, you have to find out the voltage drop across this branch. Mesh analysis is nothing but KVL only, na? Right? So you cannot write voltage drop across this current source. That's the reason why we will go for super mesh. My sincere request, one point I wanted to say here. No need to go for super mesh. Wherever the network consists of ideal current source between the adjacent meshes, that will be a super mesh network. Okay. You can solve the super mesh network with nodal analysis. Similarly, super node networks with mesh analysis. There's a very, very important conclusion, for the network analysis I wanted to keep. So far, there is no question in the gate examination, in the IES prelims examination, like solving with super node technique, solving with super mesh technique. No need. If network is super mesh, na, then go ahead with the node analysis. If the network is super node network, na, then go ahead with the mesh analysis. I'll show you. So this is the reason why I have taken the example. I have a super mesh network now, this one. So I have solved with super node. Sorry, I have solved with nodal analysis simply. Is it clear, sir? Look at this one. Find the current I. Where is I? Here is I. If you want the current in this branch, you have to calculate voltage across this branch. So I'm assigning again principal nodes. So this is one principal node, this is one principal node, this is one principal node, this is one principal node. Let me assign this as P. Let me assign. Already directly, we have only voltage source, dependent voltage source. So this node voltage is going to be Vx by 2. This node voltage we do not know. Let me take it as V2, or let me write it as V1 and V2. I want V2 only because I want current. So let us write the equation at V2 only. Where is asking, there only you try to find out. Unnecessarily do not calculate entire node equations. Okay, so already has given I. So I, let me write it as I1, let me write it as I2. All the currents are leaving. Okay, I'm not writing KCL equation now. Directly I'm converting into Ohm's law. So I can be written as V2 by 1. I1 can be written as V2 minus Vx by 2 divided by 3. I1 is the potential difference divided by resistance. Na? V2 minus Vx by 2 divided by 3. I2 is quite opposite to 3 amperes. So I can write here, minus 3 is equal to 0. So solve this one, you'll be getting V2 1 plus 1 by 3 minus Vx by 2 by 3. So you are going to get Vx by 6 minus 3 is equal, or minus 3 can be written as plus 3 onto the right side. So if you are able to solve Vx value, if you can solve Vx value, then you can find out V2 value. And you can find V2 value. What is Vx? Vx is the voltage drop. Vx is the voltage drop across 2 ohms. Vx is the voltage drop across 2 ohms. If you are able to calculate this Vx, then substitute here, you will get V2. V2, how do you calculate? Current flowing through this resistance, C2 resistance. Okay, let us calculate current now here. Let us calculate current. If you wanted to calculate current, apply KCL at this juncture. Apply KCL at this juncture. I know current coming towards this node as 2 amperes. I know current leaving from this node as 3 amperes. So what will be the current? What will be the current has to enter? What amount of current has to enter here? I. So if you write KCL, I plus 2 is equal to 3. So I is equal to definitely 1 ampere. 1 ampere current has to flow in this direction. Then you will get 3 amperes. If 1 ampere current is flowing in this direction, then the entering terminal, current entering terminal will be positive here, current leaving terminal will be negative here. So Vx will be, how we are going to get, let me write, 2 ohms, current is 1 ampere current is flowing in this direction. So 1 into 2, 2 volts drop. But actual polarities are opposite. So I can write Vx is equals to minus 2 volts. Is it clear, sir? Is it clear? Apply KCL, you will get 1 ampere. So 1 ampere current direction is in this way, right to left. So polarities will be, when the current is flowing in this direction, so polarities will be positive here, negative here. But given polarities in the question, opposite. So that's the reason why I have taken it as Vx is equal to minus 2. So now substitute this value. So you will get here 1 plus 1 by 3, or probably 1.33. So Vx is equals to 2 na, minus 2 na, minus 2. Minus 2 by 6 is equal to 3. So solve this one. You will get some value. So minus 2 by 3 will be anyhow, plus 2 by 3, it will be 1 by 3. Now send on to the left side. So 3 minus 1 by 3, you are going to get some 8 by 3. And left side, we have got 1 plus 1 by 3 na. Let me solve this one so that I have to solve for the other. So probably you are going to get it as 2. Check this one, sir, if I made any mistake. There is a procedure. So once V2 voltage is known, now you can calculate current. So VI is equal to V2 by 1. So 2 by 1, you are going to get 2 amperes. Okay. 2 by 1, you are going to get 2 amperes. Is that clear, sir? Now let us take up mesh analysis. So in that way you can calculate, sir. I have taken with the independent sources, I have taken with the dependent source, I have taken super mesh also. I have covered super mesh in the node analysis. I'll cover super node in the mesh analysis. Okay. So what a mesh analysis? The mesh analysis method is also to find out the voltage drop across each and every branch so that you can calculate currents and power consumptions. Nodal analysis, mesh analysis will give you same results. In any network, you apply nodal analysis. Whatever the answers you are going to get nodal analysis, with the mesh analysis also, you'll get the same. Okay. So let us calculate here. He's asking to calculate currents in each and every branch he has mentioned. See, let us see. I1 is here, I2 is here, I3 is here. Okay. Those are the individual branch currents, right? So whenever you are taking mesh analysis, measure single closed path. So this is my I1, this is my I3, like this, mesh 3, and this is my mesh 2, I2. Assign all the current directions in the clockwise, or otherwise assign all the mesh current directions in anti-clockwise, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. Do not take one as clockwise, one as anti-clockwise. Okay. Now mesh 1. Mesh 1. See mesh 1. How is the mesh 1? See, this is how the mesh 1 is like this. Let me draw it separately. Let me draw it separately. So that you can easily write the mesh equation. This is 1 ohm, 6 volts, 2 ohms. Sir, there is no 8, sir. Here is 8 is not there. I'm sorry. This is my mesh current, I1. Remember, whenever you are writing mesh equation, find out the branches which are common to the mesh 1 and other meshes. So, 1 ohm branch is common for mesh 1 and mesh 3. So, in this 1 ohm, I1 current will flow in this direction, top to bottom, and I3 current will flow from bottom to top. So, 1 ohm branch is going to carry two currents. Of course, in practice, only one current, whatever the current greater minus lesser will be the resultant current. Okay. So this branch is common for both mesh 1 and mesh 3. So two currents you have to indicate. Right. Now, two drops you have to indicate. Now here similarly, 2 ohms branch is common for mesh 1 and mesh 2. So here also I1 will flow in this direction, I2 will flow in this direction. So two drops you have to indicate. Okay, so whenever you are writing mesh 1, that mesh current is greater than, you should assume that mesh current is greater than any other mesh currents in the network. Right, so here it will be I1 minus I3 you will get. Here it will be I1 minus I2, because in the mesh current direction only I have to assign. If I1 is greater compared to I2, then current direction will be downward. If I1 is greater than I3, current direction will be downward only. If I3 is greater, it will be upward. So once you know currents in each and every branch, you can calculate voltage drops easily now. Okay. So let me write the KVL equation here, mesh equation. So I am considering all leaving polarities. I am considering all leaving polarities. So it will be plus 10 minus I1 into I3 into 1 ohm, minus 6 volt, minus I1 minus I2 into 2 is equal to 0. So if you expand, it will be like this, sir. 10 minus I1 plus I3 into 1. Of course, into 1, obviously, it is going to be same. So minus 6, and this is minus 2 I1 plus 2 I2 is equal to 0. So if you still simplify, 10 minus 6 will be 4. And send this negative to I1. Here I1 term is there, here I1 term is there. So I1, I1, minus 3 I1. Send on to the right side, it will be plus 3 I1. Okay. Now I2, so send on to the right side, minus 2 I2. I3, send on to the right side, minus I3. So this is my equation. This is my equation, mesh 1 equation. Sir, remember this, at this mesh equation, I wanted to say one thing. Whenever you are writing mesh equations, you can write mesh equation very quickly. You can avoid these two steps also. You can avoid these two steps also, so that you can get this value directly, this equation directly. You please observe. I am hiding. Please observe. This entire mesh equation consists of resistance into current, resistance into current, resistance into current, and equal to voltage source. R into I is equal to voltage. In that format, you see, in this mesh 1, we have two resistors, which are common for other meshes also. Okay. So simply in this branches, I1 current is circulating. So 1 ohm, 2 ohm, sum of the resistors into I1. So 3 I1. Next, these resistors are common for other meshes also. So that's the reason why here, you have to neglect minus I3, I into 1. So minus I3 into 1. Here, minus I2 into 2. So minus 2 into I2. Okay, sum of the resistors into mesh current, mesh one current, minus mutual resistor into the other mesh current, mutual resistors into the other mesh current is equals to voltage, is equal to voltage sources. Your current is leaving from positive, so plus 10. Your current is leaving from minus terminal from the voltage source, so it is minus 6. 10 minus 6 is equal to 4. If the current leaves from positive terminal, you can take it as plus. If the current leaving from negative terminal, you can take it as minus 6. So 10 minus 6, you'll get 4. In the same way, you can do it for mesh 2 and mesh 3 also. Let me show you here. Mesh 2. Okay. So mesh 2 equation I am writing at a time, sir. Sum of the resistors into mesh 2 current. So sum of the resistors, 3 ohm resistor is there, 1 ohm resistor is there, 2 ohm resistor is there. 3 plus 1 plus 2. 6 times I2. Next. Negative of mutual resistance drop. Mutual resistance, 2 ohms is mutual. Mutual for common for mesh 1 and mesh 2. 3 ohm is common for mesh 3 and mesh 2. So you have to remove the drops. So minus 2 times I1. Because 2 ohms is common for mesh 1 also. No? So minus 2 times I1. 3 ohms is common for mesh 3. So minus 3 times I3. That's it. Now I need to get voltage. So here I have current leaving from positive terminal. So is equal to 6. That's it. Mesh 2 equation is finished. Now mesh 3 equation. I3. Remember, mesh current is equals to individual branch current of that mesh. Individual branch current of that mesh. Okay. If you redraw this mesh 3 separately, it will be like this. 1 ampere current source, 2 ohm resistor, 1 ohm resistor, and 3 ohm resistor. Okay. In 1 ohm resistor, what is the current? I3 minus I1. In 3 ohm resistor, what is the current? I3 minus I2. Okay. So let me tell you here. I want mesh 3 current. So I3 minus I2 is entering at this junction. Okay. At this junction, I2 is joining. Na? So I3 minus I2 plus I2 is becoming it as I3. Next, in this junction, I3 minus I1 is entering. Okay, is flowing. So at this point, I1 is joining. So I3 minus I1 plus I1 will be what, sir? I3 only, no? So I3 is nothing but simply individual branch current, non-common branch current. I3 is nothing but mesh 3 current is nothing but simply non-common branch. This is common branch. This is common branch. So non-common branch is this one only, right? So the current flowing through 2 ohms is nothing but what? 1 ampere directly. If current source is there in the non-common branch, that is the value only directly. Simply you apply KCL, sir. Simply you apply KCL here. I3 is entering. So I3 minus I2. So remaining I2 will circulate like this now. So mesh 3 current directly equals to 1 ampere. So once you know mesh 3 current, you substitute here. 1 ampere. So you will get this equation as minus 2i1 plus 6i2 is equals to 6 plus 3, 9. Okay. Once you get the mesh equations, here also you can substitute I3 is equal to 1 ampere. So your equations will be very simple now here now. 3i1 minus 2i2 is equal to 5. 3i1 minus 2i2 is equal to 5. 5? Yeah, this is I3 is 1, so send out to the right side, you'll get 5. Next, from here, you'll get minus 2i1 plus 6i2 is equal to 6 plus 1, 7. You solve this one, you'll get I1 value, I2 value. Plus. Okay. Sir, here it is taking much time because three meshes are there. Okay. You cannot solve with nodal analysis. Why? Why? Because, you know, in nodal analysis also you can solve, no issues. But you can solve, no issues. Nodal analysis also you can solve. This is ground node. This is ground node. This is principal node. This is principal node. And this is one principal node. Out of that, this principal node voltage is 10. So this principal node, two equations only you'll get. If you solve this network with node analysis, you will get only two unknown equations. Mesh analysis also, of course, two equations only. Why? Because mesh 3 current is only 1 ampere. No need to solve directly. That is also two equations. This is also two equations. But it takes time. Most of the gate questions will be solved by node analysis technique. So please try to practice as many problems as possible on node analysis. Okay. So I have one more question in the mesh analysis. Find I1 when A is equals to 2 times Vx. A is here, I1 is here, I2 is here. So A is, he has given this kind of questions you can see in William Hyatt and Kimberly. So Vx, 2 times Vx. Vx is the voltage drop across 2 ohms. Chalo, write mesh I1 and I2. Please remember, assign the mesh currents in the branch current direction only. That is better. Otherwise, if you reverse, unnecessarily it will be polarity changes. So mesh 1 equation is what, sir? Sum of the resistors in that mesh, that is 5 plus 2, 7 times I1 minus mutual resistance drop. Mutual resistor is 2 ohms. Common resistor is 2 ohms for mesh 1 and mesh 2. So it will be minus 2 times I2. Because in that 2 ohms, I2 also will flow. Now, equal to voltage source. Voltage, current is leaving from positive terminal. So it will be plus 2 Vx. Current is leaving from positive terminal. It will be plus 6. So it will be equal to 6 plus 2 Vx. 6 plus 2 Vx. Now, mesh 2 equation. Sum of the resistors, 3 plus 4 plus 2. 3 plus 4 plus 2. So it will be 9 times I2. Negative of mutual resistor, 2 times I1 is equal to voltage source. In this closed path, you have only voltage source and the current is leaving from positive terminal. My mesh current is leaving from positive terminal. So plus 2. That is mesh 1, mesh 2 equation finished. Okay. He is asking I1. To calculate I1, I2, you substitute I2 here. And similarly, Vx value. So let me solve this one. So I2 will be 2 plus 2 I1 divided by 9. Now you substitute here. You will get I1 term on the left side. What is Vx? Or otherwise, let us substitute at the end. What is Vx? Vx is the voltage drop across 2 ohms. This is my 2 ohms. Vx is the voltage drop across 2 ohms. This is how it is, he has given. What is the current flowing? Current is I1. If I am assuming top to bottom, I1 minus I2 I can write. If you are assuming bottom to top, I2 minus I1 you have to write. But why I am assuming only top direction? Because the polarities are given positive at the top, negative at the bottom. If the polarities are given at the positive at the bottom, negative at the top, I would have taken it as I2 minus I1. Because according to this current direction, positive polarity will be created here, negative polarity will be created here. If you want to get this polarities, current has to flow in this direction. That's the reason why I have assumed I1 minus I2. Okay. So, now I can write Vx is equals to 2 times I1 minus 2 times I2. So, wherever Vx is there, I can replace 2 times I1 minus 2 times I2. Okay. So, I am hiding and expanding this equation, mesh 1 equation. 7 times I1 minus 2 times I2 is equal to 6. And plus 2 times 2 I1. So, it will be 4 I1 minus 4 I2. So 4i1, you will be sending on to the left side, you will be getting it as 3i1. 2i2, send on to the left side, so plus 2i2, you will get is equal to 6. Now you substitute this i2 value. Substitute this i2 value in this equation. So 3 times i1 plus 2 times 2 plus 2i1 by 9 times 9 is equal to 6. So if you solve, you will get i1. Is it clear for everyone? Be careful with the control variable. Be careful with the control variable. Okay. How the polarities are given? Control variable polarities are how actually he has given. Be careful. Okay. Right. So this is the previous one only. That is what I have taken here. So this, you try this question, sir. Homework. Try this question. So this is IY. IY. This is IX. And this is IY. This is IX. Try this question with the mesh analysis and node analysis. Mesh analysis and node analysis. If you go ahead with the node analysis now, it look like only one node equation, because this is a principal node, this is one more principal node, one node equation you might be getting. But I am damn sure that it will take much time. If you apply mesh analysis, it will take less time. You will realize, once you solve, you will realize the beauty in this question. Though the number of equations by node analysis is less, it takes much time. Mesh analysis, number of equations required are 2. It takes less time. Okay. You will realize once you solve. Please try to attempt this question, everybody. And, you express your feelings also when you are solving with node analysis, when you are solving with mesh analysis. Okay. Right. This is the IY is the, IY is, this current is IY, sir. So in this branch, IY current is flowing. In this branch, IX current is flowing. So it is 2 IY. It is 2 times IX. It is asking IX and IY. Okay, sir. Right. So that's about node analysis and mesh analysis so far. Right. If you realize or not, whether you realized or not, we have solved supernode also. You see, this 10 volts voltage source is connected across this principal node. This connected across this principal node and this principal node. Between the two principal nodes, I have ideal voltage source. I have solved this. I have solved this with the, I have solved with mesh analysis. If you are trying to apply, node analysis, of course, you can solve with this one also, with node analysis also. But I am telling you the example. Between the principal nodes, ideal voltage source is there. I have solved with super, mesh analysis. Okay. So please be remember, wherever super nodes are there, you go ahead with the mesh analysis. Very rarely it will fail. I'll show you in the today live session. Very rarely it will fail you. Very rarely it will fail. Wherever super mesh is there, you go ahead with the node analysis. You'll get it. Okay. Right. So let us take up about star delta transformation. About star delta transformation. Okay. Let me check this one, sir. Any problem is there or not. Star to delta transformation. To solve the circuits in a simpler manner, okay, it will be, it's it is also helping us to reduce a network in a concise manner, okay. But actually, these connections are three-phase connections, AC connections. We are not going to solve the AC connection problems here, like the star and delta, root 3 VL, root 3 IL, we are not going to solve. We are using these connections in the DC circuits only, and we are trying to solve them. We are trying to utilize this technique to minimize the network. Okay. So star will be like this, obviously. Okay. So let me take up it as RE. Let me take up it as RB. Let me take up it as RC. So delta. Like this. Let me take up it as R1. Let me take up it as R2. And let me take up it as R3. Okay. So it is like this, sir. I wanted to convert the star connection into delta connection. Okay, so I am just assigning terminal 1, I am just assigning terminal 2, I am just assigning terminal 3. Now I wanted to convert this star network into delta network. So delta network, it will be like this. I have taken only resistor, you can take even impedance also. So this is my R1, this is my R2, this is my R3. So R1 value is going to be, if you want to find out R1 of the delta connection from star connection, star connected values will be given to you. Now you have to calculate delta. So R1 value will be, remember simply, R1 is connected to the terminal 1 and terminal 3. R1 is connected to the terminal 1 and terminal 3. So to the terminal 1, which element of star connection is connected? RA is connected. To the terminal 2, which element of star connection is connected? RC is connected. So simply sum of them, RA plus RC plus RA into RC divided by, you wanted to calculate R1, opposite resistance you take, RB, divided by RB here. Okay, in some textbooks, maybe a delta connected resistor values are taken as RA, RB, RC. Star connected network elements are taken as R1, R2, R3. Okay, simply ohmic value. If there is a capacitor, what you have to write? 1 by j omega CA plus 1 by j omega CC plus 1 by j omega CA into 1 by j omega CC divided by 1 by j omega CB. If it is an inductor, simply j omega LA plus j omega LC plus j omega LA into j omega LC divided by j omega LB. Be careful with the capacitor. 1 by, do not forget to substitute 1 by. So similarly, R2, if you do not understand R1, please see. R2, where it is connected? It is connected to terminal 1, it is connected to terminal 2. To the terminal 1, which element of star connection is connected? RA is connected. To the terminal 2, RB is connected. So it will be sum of RA plus RB plus RA into RB divided by, to this R2, what is opposite element of star connection? RC. So RC. Like that, you can do it for R3 also. R3 will be RB plus RC plus RB into RC divided by opposite element, that is RA. Similarly, you can solve from delta to star also. Delta to star also. So if I have an example, I am taking here itself. If I have a 1 ohm resistor, 1 ohm resistance, then what will be the value I am going to get? 1 plus 1 plus 1 into 1 divided by 1. You are going to get it as 3 ohms. If a star connected network elements are equal resistors, then its delta connected network will be 3 times. So this is also 3 times, this is also 3 times. You are going to get. Okay. Let's see delta connection. I wanted to convert delta into star. Okay, this is my R1, this is my R2, this is my R3. Yes or no? The same previous value. Now I wanted to convert into star. RA, RB, RC. I wanted to calculate RA value, RB value, RC value in R1, R2, R3 format. So let me take up this as terminal 1, this as terminal 2, and this as terminal 3. Let me draw the star equivalent here. So this is how I have RA, RB, and RC. Right. Now I wanted to calculate RA value in terms of R1, R2, R3. The simple logic is here, RA is equals to, where RA is connected to terminal 1. To the terminal 1, which elements of delta connection are connected? So to the terminal 1, R1 is connected and R2 is connected. So I can write R1 into R2 product divided by total resistance, R1 plus R2 plus R3. Similarly, RB is connected to terminal 2. To the terminal 2, which elements of delta connection are connected? R2 is connected, R3 is connected. So, R2 into R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Similarly, RC also is equals to R1 into R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R2 plus R3. Right. So let me give you the values. If the delta connection has equal resistors of 1 ohm, 1 ohm, 1 ohm. Now what will be here? 1 into 1 divided by 1 plus 1 plus 1. So it will be 1 by 3. If it is 3, if it is 3 ohm, 3 ohm, 3 ohm, 3 by 3. If it is 4 ohm, 4 ohm, 4 ohm, 4 by 3. Right. Divided by 3. 1 third of delta connection. Star equivalent will be 1 third of delta connection. Okay. Here, 3 times. Here, 3 times. So please remember this one. Okay. So this is a simple. Similarly, if I have capacitor. If I have capacitor here, if I have capacitor, how should I, how you have to write? 1 by j omega C1 into 1 by j omega C2 divided by 1 by j omega C1 plus 1 by j omega C2 plus 1 by j omega C3. Inductor, it will be same as resistor. J omega L1 into j omega L2 divided by j omega L1 plus j omega L2, j omega 3. For all these three. Okay. So, this is the transformation, sir. So from this one, you can do it easily. I have some simple questions, I'll tell you. Okay. So I'll give you unequal resistors. 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm. It's delta equivalent, I want. It's delta equivalent, I want. Do not remember R1, R2 and all three, but simply this resistor, let me write it as, here I am writing it as small Ra, Ra, Rb, Rc. So, I just forget all those things. Ra is equal to what now? This resistor is connected to 1 and 3 ohms of star connection. So, simply 1 plus 3 plus 1 into 3 divided by opposite resistance. What is that? 2. 4 plus 3 by 2. 4 plus 3 by 2 is around 5.5 ohms. Ra is 5.5 ohms. Rb is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 1 into 2 divided by opposite resistance. Rb opposite resistance is 3. So 3 plus 2 by 3, it will be around 3.66 ohms. Rc. Rc is equal to 3 plus 2 plus 3 into 2 divided by 1. So 5 plus 6, around 11 ohms. That's it. Very simple calculation. Okay. You know, sometimes they'll give you the connection like this also. Sometimes they'll give you the connection like this also. Okay, this is my 1 ohm, this is my 3 ohm, and this is my 2 ohm. This is also star connection. Star connection is also named as a T connection. Delta connection is also named as, star connection is also named as T connection, Y connection. Okay. Delta connection is named as Pi connection, D connection. Okay, so the same way you can do it again. Right, you can do it. Delta to star also. Let me take up delta, pi model. So this model, this is fine, you can do it. I have this question now. 5 ohms, 6 ohms, unequal values I am giving, 7 ohms. So this is my pi connection. Pi connection is also called as delta connection. Delta connection. Now convert into star. Draw here itself. That is finished. So Ra I am assuming, Rb I am assuming, Rc I am assuming. I wanted to calculate Ra now. Ra. So to this Ra element is connected to this junction, or to this terminal. Which elements of delta connection are connected? 5 and 6. That's it. So 5 into 6 divided by 5 plus 6 plus 7. 30 divided by 18. Rb is equal to 7 into 5 divided by 18. 35 divided by 18. Okay, Rc, 7 into 6 divided by 18, sir, no. So 42 divided by 18, that's it. So this is a simple manner, right? If the network is given just a star delta, you can do it. But when the networks are bigger, then it will be useful to simplify, let's see that. Let's see that question. So you see here now, find R equivalent and I. So this is the R equivalent. For entire network, R equivalent is asking. Once you calculate R equivalent, 50 by R equivalent, you will get I. That is not a big deal. Calculating R equivalent is typical now. Okay. You see now, sir. You see. If current is flowing through 10 ohms, this enters here and divides here. Right. So current is flowing through 25 ohms and 5 ohms. So current flowing through 25 and 5 is same. So I can call it as in series. So I can replace this with 30 ohms. Next, whatever the current here and the current here may be dividing like this, flowing like this, dividing, flowing like this. But end of the day, when it comes to the end, 5 ohms and 25 ohms, again, these will carry same current. Again, these will carry same current. So this will also be 30 ohms. This will also be 30 ohms. So if I draw the network now, let me show you. This 30, na, altogether 30, these are altogether 30. So let me introduce a star connection now. So here is my star connection. You mention it as R1, R2 and R3. You mention it as here, maybe different values you can take up, because otherwise you will confuse RA, RB and RC. So now what will be R1 now? R1 will be, where is R1? R1 is here. Okay, if this is not visible, I'll hide sir later. R1. So to this element, which elements of delta connection are connected? 10 and this is 30. Be careful. This is 30, not single resistor. I can replace 30. So you are going to get it as 10 into 30 divided by 10 plus 30 plus 10. This 10 is also there. Now 30. So 10 plus 10 plus 30. 300 divided by 50. So you are probably getting it as 6 ohms. Similarly, R2. R2 is equal to what now? R2 connected here. So 10 into 30. 10 into 30 divided by again 50 only. So you are going to get again 6 ohms. R3. R2 value is 6 ohms. R3 value? 10 into 10 divided by 50. So 100 divided by 50, you are going to get 2 ohms. Similarly, I am calculating at the bottom. Here. So this entire resistor, 5 ohms and 25 ohms, is replaced with 30. Now you calculate. RC, if you want to calculate RC, na, 10 into 80 divided by opposite resistance. Sorry. 10 into 80 divided by 10 plus 80 plus 30. Okay. So let me calculate RA. Then we can calculate now. RA is equal to 80 into 30 divided by 80 plus 30 plus 10. Right. So 83 is a 24. So 2400 divided by, this is 90 plus 120, I think probably you are going to get. So 12 twos are 24. So 20 ohms. Now similarly, RB is equal to how much, sir? RB is equals to 30 into 10 divided by 120. So 300 divided by 120, probably 30 by 12 ohms. RC is equal to 80 into 10 divided by 120. So probably you are going to get 800 divided by 120 is 80 by 12. So this is how you can convert. So once you can convert now, then you can redraw the network. Okay, let me show you. At this one, I have R1, R2, R3, na? R1 value, R2 value, R3 value. To that network, I have already 10 ohms is there. This is not, do not forget this one, na? There is 10 ohms. So, minus, with the original network, the network which is not changed, I am drawing with the black sketch, sir. So this is 10, and here we'll be getting the resistance. Okay, these resistors will be as it is. Now this entire network is changed, so that is RC, RA and RB. Let me show you. Maybe RC, RA and RB, what are the values? Yeah, RA, RC, no? Yeah. RC, RA and RB. Like this. Right. Now to the bottom, what is there? Bottom. Anything is there? Any resistor? No resistor. Directly you can connect it to 50 volts voltage source. 50 volts voltage source directly. So I can draw with the black one. So now I want this current. This current. Now can't you calculate now, sir? Earlier the network looks like very complicated. Now the network is simplified. Series parallel you can identify easily. Series parallel you can identify easily. So these networks, these resistors are 10 and 20. So 10 ohms, 20 ohms. These values are known to us. R1, R2, R3, RA, RB, RC, you know. R1, R2 is equal to, I think, same value I've got, I think so. That is 6 ohms, 6 ohms, 2 ohms. 6 ohms, 6 ohms and 2 ohms. And RA, RB, RC? RA is 20, RB is 30 by 12. 30 by 12. RC is around 80 by 12. So this is how I have got. So once I have got this one, you can calculate easily now, right? So this I1 current will flow like this. I current will flow like this, enters at this junction and leaves as I1 and leaves as I2. Now I1 is flowing through R2, 20 ohms and RE. So all are connected in series or not? 6 plus 20, let me write here. Oh, sorry. This will be 6 plus 20, or otherwise simply I am adding, I am representing entire value. So 6 plus 20 plus 20, so you are going to get 46. This entire value is going to be 46. Now this side, 2 plus 10 plus 80 by 12. So 80 by 12 plus 12. 80 by 12 plus 12. So probably we are going to get around 56, 56 by 3. Okay, 56 by 3 and 46 are in parallel. 56 by 3 and 46 are in parallel. So now I can draw the network like this. 10 ohms and this is 6 ohms. Okay, so 56 by 3 and 46 are in parallel. So it's equivalent. That's it. Right, so this is going to be 30 by 12. So once you get entire equivalent resistance, then you can calculate easily current value. So 56 by 3 into 46 plus 56 by 3 plus 46. So we are going to get around the 13.2. Let me represent this as 13.27 ohms. So if you calculate entire resistance now, you'll get the current. So 50 divided by 10 plus 6 plus 13.27 plus 30 by 12. You'll get this current. And the numerator will be your R equivalent. So R equivalent is how much, sir? 13.27 plus 16, 10 plus 6 plus 30 by 12. Probably I'm getting around 31.77. So 50 by 31.77, you are going to get around 1.57 amperes. So this is how you can do the calculation. This kind of questions will be obviously time taking questions. Okay. If you know it very quickly, calculator will be allowed anyhow. You can do it very quickly. All right, sir. So this session went up to a long duration. I have some other questions also. I'll take up this question in the live because I wanted to tell you how equipotentials are going to be formed. Okay. So after that, one more question is there. You can solve this one as homework. Okay. For delta star delta connection. But I'll take up this one in the live. I'll take up this one in the live. Today's live. Okay. All right. So this is about a small discussion about the star delta connection in nodal and mesh analysis. And by the way, these are the faculty members who are going to teach on GradUp Super platform. So if you are interested in super subscription, you can take up the super subscription. Super subscription will allow you to access multiple courses, right? And it will give you complimentary card also. So that green card will help you to write a test series. So these are the GradUp Super Platform rankers in the last year 2021, GATE 2021. Right. So by the way, this is my link, Telegram channel, where you can post your doubts or comments. Post your doubts and comments. All right, sir. Sir, if you have, in so far we have solved around like 7-8 questions, I think so. If you have any doubt at any question, please comment in the comment box so that I can reply you. Maybe the solutions what I did now, maybe that might be different because my calculator, maybe I did might be mistake. Very, very minimum, I can say. Okay. Right. So please see. That is the procedure is much. Procedure is same. I wanted to once again say that. Super node questions can be solved with machine answers. Super mesh questions can be solved with node answers. Where it will be failed, we will see in the live. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Bye bye. See you.